definitely gonna be chilling out here and finishing up this lighthouse and the snail rider. Trying to get involved in this for a while, but I haven't. This is Mind Drops, Mind Drops. Thanks for stopping by, checking this out. This is my places I stream and social media and any of that stuff. But it's gonna be this that we're working on. Here we go. Pretty much finishing up this bad boy. I'm gonna paint some white, some red. Just trying to get comfortable here. Mainly gonna do white, and then I'm gonna do like a wash over the top of it, make it look dirty. And then also have some stuff that I want to try putting on. It's like a clear coat. Put it on this water part. It's supposed to have a satin finish, so I want to see if it makes it look wetter. But it already looks pretty cool so far, so I think in the end it should look alright. He's in there. So dirty. All right, well, here we go. Not gonna be too exciting, but I think once I get the red down on it and then get a dirty look to it, yeah, this lighthouse, the light broke in it. Oh. We'll cover that up. So I had to rewire a new light, so I had to break it. And breaking it, it ended up. Ended up turning out a little bit better than what I thought it would, but I think it'd give it a little bit of life once I have the once I have all the wear and stuff on it. Paint this guy, and then I wanna do a little snail rider that I did a while back that I didn't get a chance to paint him. I primed him with some primer I tried out on another project, so I'm kind of curious how it works on polymer clay, or actually that was a mixture, polymer clay and putty stuff. Procreate, I think it's called. Kind of just want to get a quick layer on here. Ah, this guy won't take too long, I don't think, to paint. Probably be... Maybe we should start the Death Star up. See if that'll make a difference here. Put it up to 60 minutes. I think it'll come all the way around back to this point. Yeah. All right, here we go. Death Star flash. You can get done in an hour. Well, a little more than an hour. I don't know how loud this stuff is, so. Anybody watching this later on here, the music is too loud or anything, please leave a comment. Although I'll probably have adjusted it by then. Just jammed out with this the other day. Kind of trying to remember things again. I think I'm also going to put like red lines around it. Like a red top. I might put white up on the top part, but kind of waiting to do that. I may have to touch the black up after I do that. I figure I want to do the holes too with black, so. Should end up making it a good time to paint the other part up there beforehand. Even though I had to break this, the areas I broke it in don't really look too bad once you got paint over it. Kind of funny. Trying to do this so that it's not the worst angle. White's kind of a color that's hard to auto. A little better. I don't know. I don't think I'm gonna get away from it. Messing with the camera. That's a little better. Looks a little bit more. What I see it. I'll end up taking the video in the end and time lapsing off from it. I think I got it set up to where. Just record as the one camera. It's not such a big deal. Got a couple other things I want to work on. I got some. After I get this painted and snail rider painted. I had a blank there on what I was calling them. Once I have them painted, this painted and that, then I have some morels I want to finish up. Might want to get a little bit finer paintbrush. Get down in that place. I don't want to paint the house white, but I don't want to get too much on them rocks. I think I'm going to do the house with roof red. Keep this black or white. That's all I need this little brush for. It's getting... First time ever doing like a scenery. I never really thought about trying to do one. Might want to try to do a little castle too. Out of four blocks. I think that'd be kind of neat. And I just figure I finish these ones up and I got a bunch of things I've been putting off for projects that I want to get worked on. I haven't really been able to sit in my chair for a while, so just touch up along all these fine points and get that out of the way, because it's hard to get in these spots. I don't want to lose too much of that cool stone area there. Oh, I didn't realize there are a couple bricks here. Maybe I want to. I'm just going to go around all the edges really quick with this tiny brush. I always kind of try to push the brush up so I don't get it totally. Kind of helps getting a little bit wet on there a little bit. You guys go over it again later and make the part surrounding it a little bit brighter. This is, oops, all original brick. Use the bigger brush. Something making a weird noise. I gotta go check it out really quick. Oh. I have this like dog toy, cat toy thing that's like a ball that wakes itself up and it woke itself up. Not used to hearing it. Like, what is that in there? Kind of funny. Hear a weird noise that you're not used to. Have to go check it out. At least I do. Really hard to not get. I think it might get a little bit too wet. Dang it. Ah, it might be okay though. I don't know, since I turned it upside down. This track's really quiet. It's the unedited. I think we're just gonna go and skip it. Sure, the music's not too loud. Because it can be a little bit loud. This stuff's just All the stuff I got on SoundCloud. Don't have to worry about whose it is then. Just play whatever. It's my own music. Messing around. Nothing too serious, but kinda. Already looking like bricks, even with just that one light layer. The house kind of looks like a stucco, like I kind of wanted it to. Yep, that needs to be turned down just a little. At least on the streaming side of it. I'll go back and listen to it later and see what it sounded like. I know what to adjust. Kind of restarting this whole streaming thing again. I was having a lot of fun before doing it. Yeah, I think I'm gonna do a red riff on there, like a pure red riff. It'll match the red going around the tower, or I do like a dirty wash over it. I think that'll be all right. I think it'll make it look all right. Just trying to give it kind of same attention I would give other things. Even though it's just a little lighthouse. Well, the whole light bulb breaking on it and, well, not working after I baked it. And then getting that all squared away. Can I actually see this? Plus, I try learning a little bit of some video editing and so I'm just using plain matte acrylic here. I think this one is wicker white. Yeah, this is wicker white, matte finish. Kind of matte seemed to look really good on this it's clay for the most part. So that's probably more than I need. All right, got a bunch of other stuff to work on here, so. I'm not too worried about the windows because I want to just do that wash to get the frames to look darker. Hopefully that'll make it do that. But my goal is. So we're gonna go down here first because we had just went around the house. Might as well get the stuff that's dry. I don't even know if I want to put red on the... maybe I do. Maybe like a ring or two around the top of it. Yeah, so touch up that brown back there. Just got an airbrush kind of working too, and want to start painting more with that, but this thing was already started without it, so figured I'd finish it without it. Oh, that's way too much paint. Way too much. Pull that around here. This is, but can't remember how far this is into it, but towards the end of it, I remember it being cool when I was playing it. I should have like the, I wonder if there's like a player that I can use from SoundCloud. Did my tracks names come on it? Yeah, I don't know how loud it's playing on the other end. To know. I should grab my phone sometime and plug some headphones in it. See what it sounds like. I know some of this stuff has got a lot of bass to it, so. It's kind of like abstract music, in a way. Kind of how my mind is, and it's kind of abstract. Not always linear, but sometimes. Looking pretty slick. All right, I want to do that ring on the top, that really fine brush. Just wonder if I have a more fine one than this one, but. Ah. If I keep touching the white, it's all right. Ah, I touched the black. That's all right. Oh, put a piece of tape to diffuse my light. Fell up. I'll just go back and touch it up with the black. I think it'll be easier because I think gravity would work with me better. I mean, it's kind of a damaged lighthouse. Let that dry a little bit. Get the red out. Do the roof. Got some red here, and I think I wanted to add maybe a little brown to it. We got it's over here. I think just to get the red to not be so red. For the roof. get on with it and see. It'll probably dry. Probably look a little bit better when it dries. Plus, I don't want to lose the color because I'm going to have to use a finer brush to get into all the smaller areas. Finer. This one might be all right. Just work the paint over there, not really force it, you know, kind of small. That's why I'm curious how the primer I made works on the little guy, the snail rider, because I put some primer on it. I usually don't use primer, you just allow the clay to be its way. But sometimes, if you're using an airbrush, you want to use a primer, so. Keep on bumping the camera. I don't mean to. Hard not to. Kind of trying to figure out a new setup here. I had it on my left side and I felt like it was like totally in my way. Or no, I had it like directly in front of me. And I felt it was in my way because it was coming from the left side. I tend to put my weight on my left side and like lean over that way when I work, because I'm right-handed, so I had to like work through a better way. To be able to lean on here and comfortable with the camera still. Not totally used to using a camera either, so makes a big, it's kind of a difference. You want to be comfortable while you're using it too. Want to hurt your back or anything. think that'll be a good color to wash over it pretty good. Now, I don't know if I should make this just a little bit brown or red to this chimney. There's been an awakening. Have you felt it?
Yes. There's something more.
I already put a little bit of black paint into the chimney before, so I already kind of got that look to it. Side of this.
Yes. There's something
that's supposed to be dark brown. Just didn't want it to be the exact same color as the roof, because it's not supposed to be. There we go. Alright, so okay, we're gonna paint the top of this with this red here. Not quite the red I want to use, but kind of tight to get that little it would fall out of my hand at some point. That wasn't too bad of red. Oh, should I put a... I want it so dark. It's gonna be hard to do. Maybe should just follow a ring of bricks around. Yeah, it's looking cool so far. Considering when I started doing this one, I didn't know what I was going to do that day. I decided on a lighthouse. I want to say it's pretty cool. Pretty cool indeed. We should do it. Maybe do another one on the top ring, the second ring there. I think that'll be all right still. Yeah, 2 rings I think would be perfect for it. And then maybe I'll brighten up the top one a little bit because it seems like it's a little darker than what I really wanted it to be. And I'm kind of just following this ring of bricks. Like somebody went up there and just painted the ring of bricks. And they kind of moved wherever they are. And then I don't gotta worry about the patchwork on it either, though. I was wondering how I was gonna cover the patchwork up. A little bit of a concern I was having about it. I didn't quite have a definitive idea yet. I was thinking about doing the patchwork to paint over it for the red part. But now that I got just a couple rings up there and I think about scale. I mean, scale's pretty big. You'd see that in the distance, I guess. You know, the windows are pretty small. So. That's why I decided to just keep it at that. Go back up here, go back over this a little bit, make a little bit more of this red. I don't know how much of that color is really going to stay once I do that wash over it. should be more dirtier down here than up there, but. Just kind of want to. Give it a little bit of this red. Just around in it. Everything always looks a little bit better when it's blended with other stuff added to it. I think this thing is almost done. Took a little longer than I thought, but. Brush here. Oh yeah, I want to put a little bit of black into the windows. Yep, since I got it out here. I do have this paintbrush has got. Kind of a tip that'll work. Just gonna go in. It's not quite the one I wanted, actually. I want something. Something might actually work here. Much better. Up to white one more time just to make it have a really good vibrant white around everything, around all these windows and everything. So this black doesn't stick out too much. Up here a little bit of this flat black, and I got a little brown. All right, and I do want to add some green moss or something. So a couple green colors. I don't know. I'll have to get different colors out of it. Three there. Let's go back to this brush that had the black on it. So, a little bit of green. Some of these rocks here. And then I'll throw, since that's a dark green I got there, I'll throw another lighter color over in a couple spots. already did a couple touch-ups with the green grass around it because it's kind of textured up here. And I kind of liked it. But then I didn't have it. Didn't have it shown. It's really hard to see it because it's kind of dark. But why don't you cover some of it? And then grab a little bit lighter color and go over it. That kind of look better with this texture that's here. I remember I wanted to put a texture on it, like it kind of was like grass. I didn't want to, that's kind of like maybe about putting it like a little bit hanging off the edge of stuff. But I didn't know how realistic it would look being kind of like an ocean scene. But you know, you see all kinds of stuff. And the darker color, when I just put a little bit, get that a little bit lighter. It's a little too bright. Spread it out a little bit. Kind of gives it a little bit more of a life to it. Also gonna dry, so once it dries a little bit, some of the brightness of it will go away. So that's kind of what I'm hoping. Maybe a little bit of the green can be on the edge of these rocks. Gives it a little bit. Go on this side of it here too. Alright. Now you got this wash I made. Mix some just water and paint, but I thinned it out quite a bit. I haven't really used it, so she's back here for a second. I'm gonna get a paper towel really quick. Make sure I have something to dab it off with. Oh, I had a washcloth already over here. I didn't even see it. All right, so seems like it's gonna work all right. Okay, I'm just gonna put it down here first. Oh, it looks way cooler. I wonder what other colors I can use. Make a wash. Probably use any color. That looks way cooler. Oh, that was an hour. Hour, I almost got it finished. And the chair didn't really hurt. That's great. I'm just gonna do it quick. Some of this stuff. about how I want to do it. Yep, that's done. I'll call that one done. Oh yeah, I want to do the... You guys are gonna get... Now I got this clear coat stuff. Got it. It's from Cosclay. Kind of want to see if it would coat this stuff that's a little bit flexible. It says you can do it on paint. I just don't want any more of those pieces to break off, so. Oh. Give it a little shake. And we're going to squirt a little bit in there, and then we're going to paint it on. It says to do a couple coats. Since we're done, we're not going to spray anymore. Put any more stuff on it. And I could probably put like a matte finish over it, but. One of these other brushes, because I don't know exactly what it's going to do. Supposed to be like a satin finish, so see what it ends up doing. I painted this a while ago, so I don't really care if it has a shiny-ish finish. Or if I kind of put it on thick. As long as I don't draw the paint off from it. Really what I'm hoping. I was going to use nail polish, but then I read something about using nail polish that nail polish won't harden on some polymer clays, so before I decided to do it on an actual project, I figured I would actually try it out and see on some test stuff. But I hadn't got to that yet. It does have a kind of a shiny look to it, but then again, that's kind of what I hope with it contrasting with the matte finish paint, that it'll kind of give it that look of wetness, so it looks like water splashing. I mean, it kind of looks like water still, but I want it to look more like water. More like water. But this actually is looking pretty good as long as I keep on putting moving it around on it. I think it'll be all right. Since I never used it. Oh, see, it kind of looks like it kind of dries like acrylic paint kind of does. Said it was soluble with alcohol, so. It dissolves on contact, so don't want to use that. I guess it's kind of got a little bit of a shinier look to it now, that, but it's still wet. Some other stuff here too. It's like water. I have some like varnish stuff too that's a high gloss. So I assume it'd probably be okay to use that kind of stuff on top of paint. Just keep on putting it on there, or should I put it over to the side? I do like how it looks a little bit wet now. Maybe if I set it over to the side and let it dry for 20 minutes and come back and do it again. Doesn't seem to interact with the paint at all. Yeah, I like the dirtier look to it now. So that guy's, that's done there now. Put that off to the side. If this over here, they're working on the snail. I haven't really decided the colors I want, but I know that leaf is gonna be green on top, so we can do that right away. We already used the green a while ago. Make it just a tad darker. A little bit of that black over there. So this guy here, the next one we're gonna paint. Should we throw on a timer again? Hello, master. Timer again. Hello, master. Hello, master. End point is there. I gotta stretch my leg for a second. Stretch out for a second. All right. Just stretching out a little. It's been sitting for an hour there. Kinda. Maybe we'll do like a base on this guy, green for his body. I'm just gonna have that be down there, so it'll be something on it. He's not gonna be green though. Just pretty much want a base coat down. And then we can figure it out from there. Alright, so. Okay, that's a base coat for him. I don't wanna. Nail should be looking like a golden color. So I am gonna do that whole wash thing again, so it'll get dirty. I like a golden, king gold maybe? Just with a little bit of some silver. Or not silver, black, I mean. Tone the color down a little bit on it. So, got that paint open there. Get back to my... yellowish gold color. Get rid of this. This one. I think I want to take this color here and mix it with that brown. Get more of a... yellowish brown gold color. I think that would be good for this guy. I think we're just gonna start painting him up right here. That primer I made seems to take paint pretty well. Now that I've got the paint over it. Little bit. Still think it'll probably have to take a coat or two. Well, maybe not. Sorry, I left that holder on us. Maybe like holders to work on my stuff with. Don't hurt my hand so much holding on to it, trying to paint it, trying to curve it. This helps some. Oh yeah. Oh, it's, dang it. Green is still a little bit wet. All right, we'll move on, go back to it. Painting's always kind of a fun thing and not a fun thing for me. I like doing it, but kind of get irritated by it sometimes, like right now. I see all that green down there, but I pulled it out of there and I didn't really wanna. This is kind of the first coat too, so first coat always kind of goes on really light. But up here where it's dry and go way down there. A lot of times it's kind of like working in layers too, like just getting this base layer down and pulling out the rest of it on top of it. This guy's got some little satchels on it and stuff. Pretty cool. Supposed to be like a little plant guy. Go inside of my house plants. green on there again. Dang it. All right, so put that one down. Some more brown, but I don't totally want the red in it. Huh. Cats by the dog. Hey, good to see you too. Thanks for stopping by. Yeah, I've been a little rusty. Haven't done this for a while. Yeah, a couple things I finished up the lighthouse. I'm putting another coat of the satin finish on the water, but that one's done. Turned out pretty cool. Pretty excited about it. His chair in this dark color. Try to spread this dark color on this whole chair. The other snail rider is kind of on like a gold and silver snail. This one's not going to be on the lavish one. He's not riding on a turtle, so. Oh, I'm sorry to hear that. Well, at least everybody was around her. That's good. Sorry to hear that, though. It's always sad to hear loss of any kind. Let's not play this song. Where are we at here in the list? Uh-huh. My mom's first pet. That's cool. So I bet you that's kind of exciting. I know my dog's been pretty exciting having her. That's cool. We're just gonna do it like just a plain black on the bottom here. I don't know if I can totally get it in there. Yeah. And it's like the tip of the paintbrush is not letting go of the paint the way you want it to. It's a bummer. Kind of tough. I'm just going to go over these really quick here with black, but I want to put brown over them. I don't got to worry so much about that little corner there because I can touch it up. Oh, really? First time you've been outside in a long time? How's the weather? It's awesome to hear that. Bumping the light or the camera. Not totally used to it being there yet. It's gonna take me a couple streams where I get used to it. This is cool. This one's made out of all things from my kitchen besides three sounds, I think. So cool. I just remember like collecting the sounds when I made this song, going through my kitchen cupboard. I was geeking out. It's not that cool, but still is cool. I did get a video almost edited. Two for YouTube. From some streams. One of my first streams. Kinda trying to get some stuff. Kinda getting some stuff kinda started and finished. Oh, you guys are out of water for a while, huh? Making like a fort. Yeah, I've been kind of laid up the last couple of weeks, so. Looks like a packer snail right now. Get this base layer down. I actually want most of the stuff to be in brown, but having it coated with a black on it before I paint it brown, going up in some of these tight places, I'm gonna let it dry and I'll go back over it with that yellowish gold color. Kind of get that color to look a little bit more how I wanna. I want it to be more of like a brownish color versus a packer yellow. Packer gold or whatever. It looks like yellow to me. Alright, so that's kind of the point. Let's try to go back to this gold color. Yeah, it looks way better as a brown color than a pecker gold. And then when I put that dark dirt wash on it, it'll really make it look a lot better. We're not planning on doing a whole lot for Christmas. I haven't worked for like a month and a half right now. But that's okay. I'll get through this. Yeah, we got a little bit of snow, but not much. This chair is so much nicer. Kind of making them look like they're dirtied up leather, kind of. Okay. The guy on top yet. Black. Yeah. finer tip. Fine, I need it though. Oh, it's already been that long. Crazy. I didn't even think I've been streaming that long today. You have to watch the dog. You got bird stuff for Christmas? Oh, that's cool. I got a cushion for my chair. And I got a few things throughout the year. I bought some clay not too long ago. So right now I have like way more than enough to do all the projects I want to work on and then some. So I want to start working on them. Trying to finish up some of these smaller ones just to have them done. I don't like having stuff left. Get some more black on this part up here. You can really see it. Let that brown dry, and now I think I want to do like should I like add some like weird dots to the snail. A little bright on the camera, but looks pretty cool on here. L Rider's coming out pretty cool. Almost done. Okay. Let them dry for a second, and I still want to try to do that. Wash over it. Kind of just letting it dry a little bit here. I don't have to let it dry too much, so it's kind of already pretty dry. I think this is plugged in. I could probably. Dry off as much as I can. So, I kind of just want to go around the snail. Yeah, we'll just go. Oh. I just want to make him have like a yellow jacket or something out up there. Really see him. Or maybe even. Maybe he's wearing like a green sweatshirt or something. Yeah, I think that's cool. Oh, there's like a little green spot. Good. Thank you. It goes back around and plays again. I didn't think it did that. Huh. That's weird. Go back up to the top. Yeah, I think this guy's about done. So, I think that is about it for today. I got some mushrooms I want to paint, but you grab the airbrush and do that with an airbrush. That's what the plan is for that. I think I might want to make a lighter wash, maybe like a gray. They do look cool though. Lighthouse turned out good. Definitely was cool for the project, you know? This coating on there. It's all dried up. Supposed to help it from cracking, I guess. Come on, do just a little bit more of a layer on that part, and then we're gonna call it done. Just do another quick coat. It's a nice feeling having a couple things done I've been working on for a while. Just because they've been sitting here doing nothing with them. But I kind of did get something set up. I set up a PayPal, I set up a Patreon, set up an Etsy. Got a minds.com site set up or thing made. I did get some things done in my time away from sculpting. So, I wish it would just stay shiny though. Like, even just that little bit, make it look that much cooler. Since this is like a sealer, like a clear coat, kind of to help keep the flexibility ofness of it and not let it tear. I think that maybe I could still throw a little bit of that enamel. Not enamel, It's like a gloss varnish for interior and exterior craft stuff. Just to get it to make it look a little wet would probably be cool. And then I could know if I could use it for other stuff. So I don't think that this clear. Oh, there's 2 hours of Star Destroyer countdown. Or Death Star countdown, whoops. Yeah, a little over 2 hours. I don't know, that's not too bad for my first time getting back on here. Hope that Snail Rider and it's kind of dark. I kind of like the dark look of the Snail Riders, though. I think the turtle and stuff, they should be more natural dark tones. I'm pleased how these things came out. So, anybody coming by watching this, I appreciate everybody. If you want to support me or check out my Facebook or Minds or Discord, I have a link in the description or in the about. I stream on DLive, Twitch, and YouTube, so I'll be back again, preferably tomorrow morning. All right, thank you for coming by. This is Mind Drops, Mind Drops. Calling it a day.